guys, Kielse, the Skills Method.com, that's for Selection.com. I have another story for you. You know how I love telling you stories. So, this happened over 20 years ago. I met this really hot Cuban girl, Jasmine. Shout out, Jasmine. She was really cute, but she was a virgin. So, I de-virginized her, all right? I took her cherry, popped her cherry. And, you know, I don't know if you guys have been with virgins, but virgins are really, really, really tight. Way tighter than the hand grip. And remember, I was younger there. I had much more testosterone. So you know how younger guys are, you know, with the premature ejaculation and shit. Anyways, so every time I bang her, I will put it in. And I will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I come. All right? Because she was super fucking super super tight. So we kept dating, and the same shit. Every time I put it in, I would bust it out, and you could see her face so disappointed, you know. And I was her first and only, okay. So finally, after like the 20th time I banged her, she had enough, and she told me. After the 20th time I banged her, I put it in. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4. I came, and she told me, she said, "You know what? I'm gonna tell you something. You are the worst lover I ever had, and I have nobody to compare you with." Skills at the skillsmethod.com, that's from seduction.com. Shout out to all the fuckboy, hostler, busters, players, pimps, was natural, gigolos, max, playboys. Fuck it, everybody. Today we're gonna talk about the fundamentals. We wanna start the year the right way. Okay, I wanna focus a little bit more on dance floor game. Okay, I know I took a long time to cover dance floor game, but all the other videos are the building block. So you can succeed at dance floor game, okay? So you need to cover those things. Because as I said in my first video, dance floor game is not just going to a club and dancing and being a dancing monkey. That's not dance floor game. Dance floor game it covers a lot of things. It's a lot of things I do to be successful. Okay? So now we're gonna talk about the fundamentals of dance floor game, club game. Okay? Dance floor game, club game, that you know, dance. Club game is huge, but part of club game is a huge, it covers a lot of things, but one of those things that covers club game is dance floor game. So a lot of things that I'm going to apply are mainly focused on dance floor, but they apply to club game, okay? Now what is fundamentals? Like if you go to school, right, what are the fundamentals? You need to learn math, you need to learn how to read, okay? If you do martial arts, you need to learn the basic punches, the basic kicks. So a lot of the things I'm gonna tell you is fundamentals, is the things that the building blocks that you need to be successful, again in clubs and in the dance floor, that in my experience will give the best results. Because what is game? Games is field tested actions that based on experience and trying things out yield the best results. For example, if a girl is walking down the streets and you go psst, psst, that's not gonna work. Okay, so if you try that 10 times and you go psst, 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 the girl is gonna keep walking no matter how attracted she is to you. Okay, because that's wrong. Now, if you go up to her and say, "Hey, real quick, listen, I think this is kind of random, but I think you're attractive. And I wanted to find out if your looks match your personality and skills. Nice to meet you." And you hold her hand. Probably that made you higher probability that okay? Especially if you're dressing nice, if you smell good, if you work out, etc. By the way, talking about working out, guys, you better be getting in shape. I already lost like 5 pounds of fat. Okay, you better start getting in shape for the summer. Okay, in the summer there is no excuse. If I'm doing it at this age, you should be in shape right now. Okay, I'm already dropping a lot of weight. You can see my face. Okay, honey, my body. Okay, in the next videos you're gonna see that I'm losing weight. Now, guys, let's talk about the fundament. It's a lot of fundamentals. I have about 20, so we're gonna start with number one. But I don't like the videos to get too long. So I may play my ear until I get tired, until I get the I'm losing your attention. So I'm gonna start with number one. Okay, I think it's very important that if you go to clubs, you hang out with the maximum one guy. Okay, maximum one guy. I personally, it's very difficult. I think, and Todd did a video, I mean, link it, about wings and things like that, how to be a good wing. I kind of agree with him in a lot of things there, in that video. A pretty good video, so I want to link it. But one of the fundamentals is not hanging out with too many guys, okay? Not hanging out with too many guys, because when you're with too many guys, it creates a lot of problems, okay? If you're gonna go to a club, like I go always to the same clubs, so I get in free. If I have a bunch of guys, okay, I'm gonna have problems getting in free and fast, okay? Because the bouncers don't want a bunch of guys in the club, all right? So that's problem number one. If you're with a bunch of guys, it's very, very difficult to have guys that have your adding into seduction and things, and they're not at your same game level. Okay, so that creates a problem, because what happens is, if you are with guys let's say in the dance floor, right? If you are with a bunch of guys, okay, the girl, you're gonna intimidate the girls, versus if you are by yourself dancing or whatever, it's easier to open or to get open. Or to cause a girl to do things so the girl can open you, okay? Gunwish call it hoovering or forcing approaching by things like that, so you can get open. If you are with a bunch of guys, it's harder to do that. Also, a lot of guys, if you are with guys, they make tons of mistakes. And in the dance floor, sometimes they do the circle, I call it the circle jerk. A bunch of guys in a circle dancing by themselves. I mean, it looks fun and it could work because it draws attention. But if you're gonna do that, do it briefly. But again, I call that a hub. Sometimes I do that, like, that doesn't work for seduction. But what works is, let's say you come here briefly, then you go out and do your thing. But that circle jerk all night long, doing all the dancing shit, that those guys don't get laid. Those guys don't get laid. I don't care how good the dancers are, they don't get laid. It's like a circle jerk. Now, again, you can use it to your advantage. I sometimes go to that circle jerk for 2-3 seconds, bust a couple of moves. It's a way for me to see which girls are giving me the eye, then get the hell out of there, and then probably game that girl, you know? Or probably game some other girls. And if things go wrong, or I get rejected or something, maybe come for a little bit just to recharge energy, you know, to look social, and then get out. But that circle jerk doesn't work. And if you have a bunch of guys, like standing, a bunch of guys, or going to the same gear, it's not gonna work, because the gear is gonna get intimidated. Also, there is another problem. In the clubs, there are limited gears that you like. So what happens if those guys like the same girls you like, okay? So how do I handle it? I rather, my style is this. I go to the club by myself, okay? But in the clubs I'm very popular, so I have guys that I know, okay? So I may hang out one or two, I hang out a little bit with the guys, okay? And then I go on and do my thing. And then come back and do my thing, okay? And you gotta be careful that your wing is not making mistakes, because if he's making a lot of mistakes, like parking, like doing stupid things, fighting or whatever, and the girls think you're with him, you're guilty by association. So his value in the club will go down, but you, by being with him, your value will go down as well, okay? So it's really difficult. Like, the best seducers hang out by themselves. Gambler hang out by himself, for a fact. Steve Java, he's one of the best, he hang out by himself. TVster hang out by himself, or he hang out, he doesn't like to hang out, or hang out with really, really, really good seducers, like the top guys, okay? That's a way, but you know, most people don't have access to the top guys. It's very difficult to hang out with top guys, okay? Because the top guys will do their own thing, okay? It's very difficult to connect with them. I hang out with a bunch of wings, and they all suck. I mean, the best one was the one that is the minion version of me, Primo. He's pretty good. He's pretty good, but what happens is that my style is, like I said in the previous video, masculinity, a scumbag, douchebaggy game, I'm a sexual threat. He's more like a socialite, like the rich clover, you know. He is a different contrast, because he brings the appearance of sugar daddy or high status. My style is scumbaggy, so sometimes that causes problems or friction in the game style.
His style is
more like Drew Hafner. My style is more like a scumbag style, like maybe Russell Brand, something like that. So there is a contrast in style. But it doesn't matter. I mean, me and him do good because what we do is we adapt to each other's game, okay? I just don't try to fuck up his game. Or keep the cop block occupied, or things like that. Or if I see that, when a wing is good, is when, like Todd says in his video, watch Todd video, I'm gonna link it, is when there are two girls. When there are two girls, that's when two girls and two guys, that's when having a wing works, okay? Because that way, he keeps one occupied, okay? One occupied, and women have a group mentality, so if you're seducing one, they think of it as a shared experience, like, you know, oh, me and you are hooking up with two guys. So girls like that. Girls, like, for some reason, they like that, you know. Sisters hooking up with two guys, with brothers, or two best friends hooking up with two best friends, or cousins hooking up with cousins, with two other cousins, male, whatever, you know, like, so that's exciting too, so they can talk about it, whatever, between each other. So, because, you know, they have something to talk about, a shared experience, okay? What is the problem, however, and I learned this from TVster, okay? But he's 100% right. It's a dude named TVster, TVAOS. He writes for Chase Law. So, what happens is when you have a win, you have to calibrate to each other's game. You have to escalate, to touch at the same time, you have to pull at the same time. Everything has to be coordinated, because if one fucks up, the other one's gonna get cock blocked. So it's again, like, TV still has a win called Pelucita, but those guys are like really high level, really high level. And even then, TV still has a report where he was pissed off because Pelucita fucked up one of his pulls. He was gonna pull and Pelucita fucked it up. That was the first time they went out. But now they have each other's rhythm. It's the same with me and Primo. At the beginning, it wasn't that good. And then we learned each other's rhythm, so we got better and better. And to the point that he fucked four girls, and they're very high quality girls, A+, okay? So, again, my style, again, guys, if you decide, okay, no, I don't like going out myself, I'm not comfortable,
I think you should be you should learn how to go out by yourself. Okay, throw yourself. It's very uncomfortable at the beginning, but once you master it, you will love it. You won't want to go out with wings. Okay, like again, me and Primo, we hang out, or me and my other wings. They're not as the level of Primo. They're not as good as Primo. So what we do is we hang out sometimes, and then we do our own thing. Okay, because they know how I am. They know how I am. That I'd rather be alone. Okay. But this is key. If you're gonna hang out with the wings, have different cars. Okay, have different cars. Because another problem that you have with wings is that, let's say you hook up with a girl, because this happens a lot. You hook up with a girl, the guy said, oh, let's go to another club, oh, let's go here, or I wanna go there, or I wanna go home. Now you drop, or he drop, so now you're fucked. Okay, now you're fucked, now you're stuck. So if you're gonna hang out with wings, hang out in different cars. If you're gonna hang out with wings, make sure you're at the same level, or he's a little higher, so you can learn from him. If you hang out with wings, make sure that if he makes mistakes, just go on your own, okay? Go on your own, or go to another club or something, or do your own thing, because again, it's gonna be guilty by association.
Okay, guys. So, in conclusion, so let me give you the take about wings, okay? Because I think this is one of the fundamentals, okay? So, in conclusion, if the guy's attractive, excellent. Because guilt by association, okay? Guilt by association, because if the guy's attractive, he's getting girls. Again, Primo directly got laid with 4 girls due to being with me. Okay, so if the guy's attractive and he gets girls and he can pass off to the girls have friends, okay, they're gonna want to share his experience. That's if they are attractive. Now, on the flip side, if the guy is making mistakes and you got a girl, he has a friend, and he's only two girls and you're two, he may fuck up your night. Okay, he may fuck up your night. Okay, so that's one. Also, if, for example, like high level players, they may challenge each other. Oh, I'm better than you, let's get that girl, let's do this, let's do that, so you compete, okay, you compete. Like, there was a time, sometimes after a breakup, I didn't want to, usually after the breakup, I didn't feel like picking up girls, whatever, they would challenge me, so it gives you that fire to go get girls, so that's a good advantage. The flip side, the opposite of that is, sometimes you're gonna get a gear just to impress your friend for validation. It happens because you want to show off for your friend. So that's kind of bad, you know, that's kind of bad. Like sometimes, you know, your friend is there and you're trying to show off and to you know, that happens a lot. That happens a lot with seduction gurus. That sometimes you have a guy that is your wing or a student, and you have to show, oh, your skills, oh, you took a lot of shit, can you get that gear? And then you have to get gears that are attractive, but not your type, just to show off. So I personally don't like doing that. But it comes with the territory of the business we chose. Okay, sometimes, one problem you may have with wings is that a lot of them are full of negativity. Okay, so if you're in a club and you're like me, I'm very positive, I'm very high energy, very happy. But if the guy is full of negativity, oh, this club sucks, the girls are not good here, the music is too loud, it will bring down your energy. So that's bad. But then there are guys, I mean, I still haven't met them. There are guys that be like, as I said, especially, like, hey, come on, let's go, eh? Oh, no, it's cool. There are girls here. Come on, get in the song. Those are good guys. I still haven't met anybody like that. I'm like that, but I haven't met anyone like that. Now, there is another problem. Sometimes there is jealousy. Okay, I had wings. I had a wing named Armando. He would sabotage me. And then there was another one, Keith, like a neighbor. I had a neighbor, Keith. They would sabotage me, man. They would talk like, oh, he's a player, and this and that, to girls behind my back. We call it in the community white-eyeing, which is saying, that guy's horrible, that guy's bad,
I wouldn't do that. I would be like this. I would be such a good guy. I would be like that. So they're selling to the gear while putting me down. So those are not good wings. Okay. Another thing about wings, if they're good skill level, like for example, like I said in the other video, I learned from two guys from Caesar and Number One. I mean, right now they're here. They were here. I was here. I learned their skills, and I went. I mean, I already right now the game sucks, you know, because it's very hard, guys. It's to be a seducer for years, which is pisses me off. You guys in the forum, you piss me off, all of you. When I see a freaking young guy, which is 18, 19, going through a hot streak of 2-3 years. Oh, dad, I'm so good. Hey, motherfucker, you have 2 years doing this shit. Go through 25 fucking years of relationship, rejections, freaking girls crashing your cars, great girls slandering you, girls, all this shit, 25 years. No. The player's life is 5 to 10 years, and then they get out. Okay, it's a lot of, as I said, guys, it's a lot of rejection. It's not easy. Okay, it's not easy going night after night after night after night for years, year in, year out, year out, year out, year in, year out. Yeah, getting older, more responsibilities, more shit, more society pressure. Doing this for 25 years or more is not easy, without break. Okay, so that's anyways. Okay, I get a little pissed because guys on the phone piss me off sometimes. Okay, but anyways, so as I was saying, when you go out with good wings, they cut your curve. Your it's better than any book, any forum, anything, because they are live right there. You can see live what they're doing. Okay, so you can learn really fast. So that's what happened to me. I got lucky that I met. Lucky and not lucky, because these guys are. I mean, they didn't even want to show me what they were doing, but I was smart enough to see, okay? And they were full of shit. That's another thing, guys. Be careful with wings, because I was searching who is good with women all the time, all around. And I hung out with surfers, I hung out with preps, I hung out with fucking dancers, I hung out with gangsters, I hung out with druggies, I hung out with everybody. I never did drugs, though. To see which guys do good with women. A lot of them were full of shit. So if you're with guys full of shit, that could cut your learning curve. But if you go out, with a guy like me, if you go out with a guy, let's say TVC or a guy named Cost of Success, a guy named Pure Evil, Gone Wish, guys like that, you know, Mystery. If you go out with the artists, the good. If you go out with those guys, you will learn. I mean, as long as they're legit, okay, good-looking loser, all those people. If you go out with them and you're always with them, it's gonna rub up, because you're the summary of the people you hang out with. So if they're good with game, you'll become good. If they're bad with game, you'll be fucked. Also, guys, be careful, because a lot of the guys at the forums, they hang out with super good-looking naturals. Like 6'1", supermodel looking, that get approached. Those are outliers, and that doesn't really happen, but that could fuck up with your head. There is a seducer, I forgot his name. Subserge, something like that? I forgot his name. But that guy hung out with a supermodel, so now he's all fucked up. Like, oh, I'm not good looking enough. All that. So that could fuck you up, okay? That could fuck you up. So if you find yourself in a situation like that, you have two choices: either become as attractive as that guy, or just take a break and hang out with somebody at your level of attractiveness that is good with women, so it doesn't fuck up with your head. Okay. Anyways, guys, that's all I got. This is so the fundamental number one in conclusions is hanging out with too many guys is not good for game. It's not good for game. Okay, and I'm gonna put Todd talks about wings. I like his he did a video recently about wings. I'm gonna put it on the link, and I'm gonna put a link, an article that I did of hanging out, starting solo, hanging out, going out solo by yourself, the advantages and disadvantages that may help you clear up. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna, this is gonna be a long series of what I think is fundamentals on clubs games, okay? Again, guys, whatever I say doesn't mean shit unless you go out and observe for yourself, experience the things I'm saying for yourself, okay? As always, guys, like, subscribe, get the book, okay? If you don't like it, I'm not for everybody. You can suck on my left nut because my right one is the reproductive. Get the fuck.